I stand here with a heavy heart and also as a grateful and proud daughter. I have had an incredible 67 years with my dad. Not many people get that time, and I'm so thankful. I will be brief today to help me make it through this and to make Dad smile, because a lot of us in this room know how much he appreciated brevity. I want to start by thanking all of you for being with us today. I think I can speak for Elizabeth when I say the outpouring of love and respect is so heartwarming. We are truly lifted by your presence. And thank you, Mr. President, for your warm remarks. I'll always treasure your recent visit to Dad and Elizabeth and I at the Watergate. It was wonderful, and I loved listening to you share all your stories about the time you served together. And I want to say thank you to his extended family, and now mine, former colleagues, former staff, current staff, members of his household, Elizabeth's staff, who I've gotten to know really well this last couple days, the brunch crew, all of his visitors and friends and family who called him regularly. He so enjoyed his time with all of you. And I want to say thank you to his medical team, and believe me, it was quite a team. His team on the East Coast and the West Coast, for your dedication and for giving us so many wonderful years with Dad, especially this last year. We can't thank you enough. Finally, I want to thank his caregivers. I will be eternally grateful to you for providing extraordinary care and compassionate care to my dad, and for always answering my many calls and texts with grace. There were a lot, believe me. The last years have been such a gift to me. I feel so fortunate I was able to spend hundreds of hours with my dad and talk to him almost every single night on the phone. We talked about everything under the sun. He told me things I never knew. He asked about my life, about my friends' lives. We made lots of calls to family, to former colleagues in the Senate and in the House, to former staff. He shared feelings he had not shared before with many of these people. It was a wonderful experience for me to listen to these conversations, and such a gift to them and to Dad. My dad is the most generous person I have ever known. He was a giver, not a taker. He cared more about others than he did about himself. He told me he set a personal goal to help at least one person every day of his life. Then he said, "I'm not sure I've been able to meet my goal." I said, "Dad, you've got to be kidding. Some days you help one person, and other days you help 40,000 people. I think you've met and exceeded your goal." "Well, you may be right," he said. There is no one he helped more than me. He's always been there for me, through thick and through thin. He always had my back, even when I made mistakes, and believe me, I made quite a few. He believes in giving second chances, and I know that firsthand. He was my rock. My dad was an animal lover, and we share that love. You've heard a lot about his work in animal welfare, but I'd like to share a few personal stories about his love for animals. When I was a little girl, my cousins and I would visit his parents in Russell every summer. Grandma would often have animals for us to play with. One year when I got home, I cried and cried because I didn't know what would happen to the little kitten that I played with and grew to love. Dad left on a trip to Kansas, and much to my surprise, he brought the kitten home with him on the plane for me. We named the kitten Rusty because he started in Russell. Recently, I lost my dog, Cooper. Dad was the first one to call me. He consoled me and he said all the right things. That support meant the world to me. Soon, he began to encourage me to get another dog. Quite frequently, he encouraged me to get another dog. And I'd tell him, I just don't know if I'm ready, but he kept encouraging me, and eventually, he got me a puppy. And I wanted to name my puppy after Dad, but, you know, I didn't want to name him Bob. So I decided to name him Jojo after his middle name, Joseph. And we visited many, many times. Dad always wanted me to bring Jojo with me, which wasn't always easy, but we did it. And Dad always wanted me, when I got there, to hold Jojo up so he could get kisses from Jojo. I'd hold him up to his face. And Dad always wanted Elizabeth to get kisses, too. And Jojo did a very good job spreading his love. Dad and Elizabeth's dogs, Blazer and Leader, were always trotting into his room. They loved to visit. But it was Blazer who was the most concerned about him. Blazer would lay at his feet whenever he suspected Dad needed special nursing care. And I believe it really helped him because he loved them so much. When I was preparing to speak today, I learned about a farewell letter Dad wrote with a former staff member. None of us knew that he had written this letter. He swore him to secrecy, and he kept a secret. The joke is, you may move on to other jobs, but once you're a Dole staffer, you're always a Dole staffer. And a lot of people in this room know that. I'd like to share, in closing, part of that letter, and I encourage you all to read it in its entirety. It has been released to the public as he wished. Here are his words. As I make the final walk on my life's journey, I do so without fear, because I know that I will again not be walking alone. I know that God will be walking with me. I also confess that I'm a bit curious to learn if I am correct in thinking that heaven will look a lot like Kansas, and to see, like others who have gone before me, if I will still be able to vote in Chicago. I do have one request to make of you. Since it was dedicated in 2004, it has been my honor to go as often as I could to the World War II Memorial here in Washington, D.C., to welcome and thank the World War II veterans and all veterans who are visiting there. Since I won't be making that visit anymore, I hope that you will, and that you will ask your children and grandchildren to visit veterans' memorials across America, and to never forget the sacrifice made not just by my generation, but by all those who wear the uniform of our country. My final words are the exact ones that Dwight Eisenhower used to conclude his speech in Abilene nearly seven decades ago. I believe in the future of the United States of America. I will miss him so much. I think I will still talk to him every night. I love you, Dad, and I promise you will never walk alone.